Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing well. So in today's video, I'm going to show you the products that I regret buying. I'm never ever going to repurchase these things, guys, because it's that bad. Few products are not that bad, but I really don't like using those products and I don't reach out to them. So without further ado, let's get started with the video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe and also click on the bell button so that you will get notified every single time I post a new video. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, first I want to show you the skincare that I regret buying. There are two skincare products in here. So the first one is the Pond's Light Moisturizer Non-Oily Fresh Feel for Soft and Glowing Skin, Vitamin E plus Glycerin. Oh my god. So this is the product, guys. So this is how it looks. So this is the product. So the problem is, Pond's itself, I don't have anything against all these brands, guys, but just to clear the air. So the product, as you can see, there's a lot of products in here, but as you can see, this product is very, very cushion-like, and the consistency is light. Yes, it's very, very light, but the problem is, the moment you start rubbing this into your skin, this feels a little greasy on your skin. It feels a little heavy on your skin. But after like 20 seconds, it just gets absorbed into your skin and there's nothing. There's nothing. Literally, there's nothing. You don't even feel hydrated anymore. Your skin just feels dry. I do have combination skin and myself, I feel very, very dry after using this product. I did try this product for quite a few times, like for a good week, I would say I tried this, but I really did not reach out to this later, guys. I don't like this product. I'm not a very big fan of this product. So yeah, that's that. And the second product, so I generally like physical sunscreen, guys, but this one, I'm not, oh my god. This is the one from Sun Cross. So this is a Sun Cross tinted this sunscreen. So they say this is free from the chemical agent. So this is a, so which means it's a physical sunscreen. I love physical sunscreens, but the problem with this one, let me show you, it's very, very thick. They say this is for all skin types and especially, they call it a gel, guys. They say it's sun protect gel. Here it's given it's a gel, but it isn't. As you can see, I'll show you, let me show you the consistency of this product. Like you can see, it's like a thick cream. I hope the camera picks it up. It's a thick cream and when you blend it, you're just left with a very, very, you know, a ghostly cast, a white cast. As you can see, I've blended this on my, I've beautifully blended this into my skin, yet this looks white. So when I just apply this on my face, it looks, it leaves a very, very, very bright white cast, which I'm not a very big fan of. All physical sunscreen tends to leave a white cast, but that can be manageable. But this one is not manageable, guys. This doesn't sit well on the skin. It's extremely thick for my combination oily skin. So I feel it just, you know, weighs my skin. It makes my skin very oily. It clogs my pores. It tends to clog my pores. So I'm not a very big fan of this. It doesn't sit well under makeup as well. It doesn't sit well overall on my skin. I don't know if you know, dry skin girls would love this. I'm not very sure. For me, it's a big no-no, guys. So it's a very, very I wouldn't call it a bad sunscreen, because obviously it's a physical sunscreen, it might be good, but I'm not a very big fan of it. I'm not reaching out to this. So that's that. And now coming to hair care product, I wanted to show you a product that has got 5-star review in Nykaa. You wouldn't believe me. So I read, I wanted a good shampoo for, you know, dandruff and hair fall. So I chose this Himalayan Organics Tea Tree Shampoo. So this is how it looks. Guys, this has got 5-star rating in Nykaa and you should read the reviews about this product. So it's like everything, everybody were like, good, good, good. This controls the hair fall, this reduces the dandruff, this, that. So many good reviews. I didn't even read a single negative review. Everything like good. So I thought, okay, let me just give it a try, because I do have hair fall. But I'm someone who believes that, you know, hair fall is something that cannot, that, you know, shampoo cannot take care of. What you have inside is what, you know, it's your body, your health is what is seen outside as, you know, your hair. So, but still, I just wanted to give this a try because it has got tea tree, and I felt my I did have, you know, itchy scalp, so I wanted to try this out. So I picked it up along with the conditioner. This is the coconut milk conditioner from Himalayan Organics. So this is how it looks. Again, I've read beautiful, great reviews about these products, so I just wanted to try it out for myself. I did try for the first time, and I felt like they don't give you much lather. They don't, you know, give so much of lather for your hair. So you have to wash your hair. If you are someone who applies oil and wash your hair, like you have to wash it up for two times, twice. You have to wash it up twice. Only then you'll get rid of the oil from your hair. But I tried it for the first time, guys. Okay, I'm like, okay, all natural shampoos, all organic shampoos tend to do that. They always first for the few times it makes your hair greasy and all that. So I thought, okay, let me try it for like 3-4 times. Oh my god, this just made my hair very, very, very greasy. Like my hair got tangled very easily, and my scalp was, you know, very greasy, very oily. It got very oily, and my dandruff. I did have little bit of you know, the dandruff, seabody dermatitis, but after using this I couldn't stop myself from scratching my head so bad, and I did have a lot of hair fall because of scratching. So I stayed away from this product. I've just still so much is left because I've hardly used it for 4 or 5 times, and this much of product is left, guys, and I don't even know what to do with this product anymore because they are expensive as well, because they retail for 765 rupees. So it's not very cheap either. So I don't know, I might use this for, you know, cleaning my makeup brushes or something. I'll make use of out of it, like, somehow. And coming to the conditioner, guys, this conditioner again, I thought, okay, the hair, this shampoo is making my hair very oily and greasy. Let me try this conditioner with, you know, some other shampoo. So I thought I'll use this. So I used this alone with another shampoo that I'm using right currently. I didn't quite like it. This again will clump my hair together. It doesn't give any volume to my hair. It will just make, it doesn't give any volume to my hair. Just, you know, feels very oily, feels very, very heavy, and I don't quite like it. So guys, you know, shampoo will not take care of your hair loss. If it is genetic, you have to deal with it. And if it's something that you are going through internally, you have to take care of it, of your health overall. And yeah, I just wanted to put it out there because don't trust shampoos that will control the hair fall. It's not going to do that. But I had high hopes for this, you know, to control my dandruff, but that didn't do that either. So that's that. And now coming to one more skincare product I have. I'm so sorry. This one is from the Dot & Key. It's a Glow C Sleep Mask Vitamin C Overnight Radiance Recovery Gel. So this is how it looks. So guys, this looks very pretty, cute packaging and all that, and it's an Indian brand which I support. But this again, the consistency of the gel is very, very light. It's very, very light on your skin. It's not gonna make your skin very oily or something, but the product is, guys, it has very, very, very strong fragrance of a very citrusy strong fragrance, which I'm not a very big fan of. Generally, I don't like any fragrance in my skincare or makeup for that matter. So that's a very big put off for me. And on top of that, this doesn't give me any hydration. Or vitamin C is said to, you know, decrease the pigmentation of your skin. It helps with, you know, hyperpigmentation and wrinkles and all that, but this didn't. And it also helps with the acne scars that you have left with, but this didn't do anything at all. I've given a chance for this for 1 month, full month, but this didn't do anything to my skin, guys. I'm so disappointed. This doesn't even moisturize my, doesn't even give much hydration. So I don't quite like it. Me being a very oily combination skin, I have very oily combination skin, this didn't help me much. So I'm not a very big fan of, I don't reach it, and I just, you know, I don't use it totally. So guys, the first product that I'm going to show you in makeup is this Milani Baked Bronzer. So this is in the shade 04 Glow. So this is supposed to be a bronzer. Yeah, this is supposed to be a bronzer, but this doesn't look like a bronzer, and this doesn't, when you put it on, doesn't look like a bronzer. So let me give a quick swatch for you guys. So this is how it looks. So it's very orangey, it's very blush like, and right now maybe it looks a little bit darker than the rest my skin, but when I put it on my face, this looks like a blush. It doesn't look like a bronzer. There's a lot of shimmer, there's a lot of glitter chunks going on, which I'm not a very big fan of. Bronzer should be, it will give you glow, but I don't like the glitter chunks in bronzer, guys. This has so much of glitter chunks. I'm not a very big fan of, and my face skin tone is totally different from what I have it on my body. It's like my facial skin is like 3-4 tones, 3-4 tones lesser than my body, than the rest of my body. So I don't like this product at all, guys. There are blushes, baked blushes, which are really good, but that again has shimmers going on, and this, oh my god, I wouldn't use this. What I do, I sometimes use it as my blush. Sometimes when I do, you know, a nice bronzy look and all, I use it as a blush, but not as a bronzer. And for someone with deeper rich skin tone, you can use this as a highlighter. It really has that much of shimmer, glitter chunks. So yeah, that's that. So the next product that I totally hate is the one from Nykaa. It's a Strobe and Glow liquid highlighter. Oh my god. So this is how it looks. So this, guys, again, for my skin tone, this is very, very, very dark. This is like a bronzer, I would say. This isn't like a highlighter. This is the lightest shade that they have. There are just two shades. In that, this is the lightest shade I could get. So let me show you. Let me give you a quick swatch here. The product is very, very thick, and the dropper is of very, very low quality. It's not of a good quality. And let me show the product. It's very thick, guys. It tends to clog your pore. And this is the product. Let me blend it and show it to you. So this is how it looks. So this highlighter is quite dark for my skin tone. When I put it, I just look very, very, very tanned, and I'm not a very big fan of this highlighter, guys. So that's that. And it's very thick as well, so I don't like it. And the next product that I have for you guys, I know there are a lot of Nykaa products that are coming in, but trust me, guys, there are good products and bad products as well. So this is the Nykaa Get Cheeky Blush Duo in the shade Malibu Barbie. So there are two shades in here, the coral and peach shade. So this is how it looks. So this is a nice coral shade. That is pigmented, like you can see. So this shade is pigmented. This is the shade. This is one, this coral shade. And let me show you the peach shade. As you can see for yourself, I'm just scrubbing my finger into this. Now, can you see that? That is how much of pigmentation you get from this blush. So it's very, very bad, guys. I don't know if I've got the defective product, but I've tried using that for so many times, and I just keep scrubbing that, but that doesn't show on my skin. So that's such a bummer, I would say, from Nykaa. But in this duo, I really, really like this. I reach out to this shade a lot because it's a really beautiful orangey peach shade. But this one is such a gorgeous, I mean, coral shade. But this shade, such a bummer. I really like it. So that's that. And again, next one is again, yet again from Nykaa. I'm so sorry, Nykaa. I don't have anything against you. But yeah. So this one is the Nykaa Just Wink It Wet and Dry Eyeshadow Palette in the shade Smoking Hot. Again, this is how it looks. Guys, I don't know if I had purchased it or I got it as a I got it for free in some offer or something, but I'm not very sure. But guys, the quality of this product is very bad. It's very chalky, as you can see. It's not pigmented. It's very, very chalky. Let me show you the swatch of a blue shadow in here. It's very, very chalky. It applies very patchy. It's not pigmented. You don't get what you see on the pan itself. It's totally different. The shade is totally different, and the brown, they are not matte. They do have sheen going on, so I'm not a very big fan of it. As you can see, this is how it swatches. There's a sheen going on. There are no matte shades in here. But I'm not a very big fan of this, guys. It doesn't look good on your eyelids. And when I blend it, what happens? It doesn't feel like a powder. It doesn't feel like a cream as well. As you can see in my finger, this just crumbles in here. I don't know if you can see. This is how it looks. It just crumbles. It just becomes a hot mess in some time. So I'm not a very big fan of this. It's not really good quality. I don't like it, guys. So I don't want to talk about it further. So that's that. And next, coming to Lakmé. I do have 3 Lakmé products to talk about. Sorry, I dropped it. So the first thing that I want to talk about is the Lakmé 9 to 5 Primer Plus Matte Lipstick. This is in the shade Sorbet Tuesday. So yeah, this is how it looks. This has got a very beautiful pink color going on. Its color is beautiful, but when you apply it on your lips, this looks very patchy. It clings to the dry patches that you have. It accentuates your fine lines. I don't know what all it does. Overall, the quality I would say is not good. Really catches the dry patches that you have, and I don't know, guys, it looks, after some time, it looks like your lips are very dry. You need moisture. That is how it looks. So I don't really like this, guys. The next product again is from Lakmé Absolute. So this is in the shade Peaches and Cream. So this again, I really like nice peach colors, but I'm telling you, getting a nice peach color for Indian skin tone is very different, very difficult, very challenging as well. So I got this since the name is Peaches and Creams. So let me give a swatch for you. This is how it looks. This one. So it's a beautiful color. So guys, there are good shades in this range, but this shade in particular, the Peaches and Cream 03 Peaches and Cream, is not good. It's very moisturizing. It tends to bleed and it's very patchy. In spite of it being moisturizing, it's very moisturizing. I feel this looks like lip balm when you put it on your lips. It's not very good. It's not pigmented. It's very patchy. So I don't really like it. And the next product again is from Lakmé, which is the Lakmé 9 to 5 Weightless Mousse Foundation. This is how it looks. So guys, I've heard really amazing reviews about this product. This has a really very moussey consistency, I would say. They say this formula feels soft, incredibly weightless, and provides the desired coverage for daily use. It blends effortlessly onto skin to conceal imperfections with a matte finish that stays through the day. So let me tell you, it looks very matte on your skin, but this has got silicone in it. I'm not very sure with the ingredients because I don't find the ingredient list here. So it has silicone in here for sure. So when you put it on your skin, it looks good for some time, but after some time, I do have oily combination skin, but after some time your skin feels very dry. And the moussey consistency, the foundation just moves, slides, and it just clings to the dry patches that you have and the acne that you have. So this product, guys, is for matte skin. It gives a matte skin, but after some time, this just makes your skin very dry and patchy, which we don't want. So that's that. I'm not a very big fan of it. I don't really like it. I've not used it at all. I've just used it once in my life and that's it. I've not used it after that. So that's that. And the next product, I know a lot of people are gonna bash me for this, but I have to tell you guys, this is Smashbox Driver's Seat. So this is how it looks. This lipstick is expensive. I'm telling you, this is damn expensive. I think this lipstick retails for 1900, 2000, I'm not very sure. So the shade is very pretty, everyday kind of nude, peachy nude for me. Such a gorgeous shade. I've swatched it here. As you can see, it's just been 3-4 months that I've got this, guys, but this is totally dried up. This is totally dry inside the tube. I cannot use this product because I don't know. It was good, guys. Like when I purchased, this was liquid consistency. It was good. I really enjoyed using this. But after some time, this is totally dry. I'm not able to even give you a swatch of it because it's very patchy. And I'm not a very big fan of it, guys. And it's expensive as well. I hear a lot of good reviews about this product. I don't know if the product that I received is damaged or some defective product, but the formula, it has totally dried up inside this tube. So I don't really like it, and I feel very disappointed with this brand because, you know, it's expensive. Why do you want to waste your money on this expensive product when it isn't, when it is not going to work on your skin? So that's that. And next product I have for you guys is such a bummer, which is the Wet n Wild H2O proof, waterproof, I mean waterproof liquid liner. So this, again, this is how it looks. So guys, this doesn't show up on your skin. Again, it's not waterproof. They say it's waterproof, but it's not waterproof. It doesn't stay on your lids. It doesn't give you a matte finish. It doesn't show up on the lids. So after some time, this just becomes dry and just, you know, just crumbles and just peels off. Can you imagine? This just peels off its own. Peels off by its own. So I don't really like it. Who wants to spend, even if it is 300, 400 bucks also, who wants to spend that 300, 400 bucks in such a bummer, such a waste of product? So I don't really like this. And the next product again is from Wet n Wild. That is their Wet n Wild Cool. I don't know what it is because it has faded. So this is the product, guys. It's a nude kajal pencil. And oh my god, this product, this is how it looks. I really, really like a nude kajal on my waterline because it makes your eyes look bigger and it looks like you have, you know, beautiful Barbie like eyes. I really, really like that trend going on. But this product is very, very patchy. This doesn't apply very smooth on your lips. There are gonna be tucks and pulls, so you don't want to hurt your eyes. I did hurt my eyes twice using this. I'm not a very big fan of this product, and it's not very creamy, guys. So I really want something creamy in my waterline. So if you have any recommendation, please, please do let me know in the comment section. So I don't really enjoy this product much. And the next one is again, yet again from Wet n Wild. It's the Max Volume Waterproof Mascara. This is how it looks. So guys, this is not a very bad mascara. It's okay, I would say, but I don't reach out to this when you have good mascara at the same price range. So this one doesn't give you any volume. This doesn't give you any length. What this does is it just separates your eyelashes. So the wand looks like this. Let me just show you. So this is how the wand looks. I hope you guys can see. So this just separates your eyelashes. But when I spend like 500, 400 bucks, I want a mascara that really gives a good volume and length to my lashes. So I'm not really a big fan, and I've never used this as well, guys. I've just used it like once or twice, and you know, I've just used it maybe once or twice. That's it, not more than that. So I don't like it. And the next product is from K-Beauty. I really, really, really like K-Beauty as a brand. They have beautiful, beautiful products going on. Like, I love their matte lip crayons, their lip, their recently launched lip lipstick, the Bullet lipstick. I really like their kajal pencils, their eyebrow product, their their contour stick, their eyeshadow sticks. They are bang on. But this product, I don't know what they thought when they created this. They say this is the lip topper. This is how it looks. I'm so sorry. This is how it looks. This is a lip topper, guys. So this is how it looks. And when you apply, it looks gorgeous. Like, there's a beautiful berry kind of shade, rose gold berry kind of shade. But after some time, this just disappears from nowhere. You don't see it at all, totally. I've tried applying it on my lips, doesn't stay. I've tried applying it on my eyelids, doesn't stay. On my cheeks is blush as well, but doesn't. Just disappears from nowhere, guys. So that's really a very bad product. But yeah, it's a waste of money. They retail this for 700, 750 rupees. So I don't really recommend this product. And the next one is from PAC. I do really enjoy PAC product. PAC's foundation is top notch. They're really, really good foundation. But this one is a PAC Precision Lip Liner in the shade Warming Up. The shade is a beautiful, gorgeous shade, like you can see. It's a nice orangey, a rustic, a very, this is the shade, guys. So it's a nice rustic orange, a brick toned shade. I absolutely love the shade, but the problem is with the formula. I don't really enjoy the formula because this tends to bleed. It's very, very moisturizing. It's creamy actually, but this doesn't stay. It smudges like there's no other business. So I'm not really a big fan of it. I don't recommend this at all. I don't know if the other colors are good in this range, but this, I don't like it. So guys, the next product that I absolutely hate is from the brand called Tony Moly. It's the Pikey Bikey Art Pop Enamel Tint. So this is how it looks. The packaging is very cute, I would say. So this is how the applicator looks. It looks like an ice cream stick. So the shade is again a very beautiful dark orange color. So when you apply, this is how it looks. It's very patchy on application, but somehow when you just blend, it blends beautifully because it is moisturizing, it is not dry. This blends and looks beautiful the moment you blend it. This is how it looks. The color again is a very, very gorgeous shade, but this has a very, very strong candy fragrance, which I'm not a very big fan of. As I always say, I don't like fragrance in my skincare or makeup either. So that's that. And after application, your lips look very plump, beautiful, glossy, juicy and all that. But after some time, what happens? This pigment glides from one side of your lips and stays in the other side of your lips. Everything. Yes, trust me, this happens with this. Just imagine, when you apply, it looks normal, and after some time, all the lipstick, the tint, just glides and stays in one particular. It doesn't look cute at all. It's very, very, very bad after some time. So I hate it, guys. I don't really enjoy this. I totally, totally hate it. So I know the next product is, a lot of people are gonna bash me because it's from ColourPop. It is their Super Shock Eyeshadow Pressed Pigment in the shade Animal. Guys, this is a coral. Bright coral shade. This range of eyeshadows, the Super Shock pigments are really, eyeshadows are really, really very cult famous. It's, the formula is beautiful. I do have it in another one. I think I have the one shade called Rex. It's beautiful. There's no problem with that shade, but the problem is with the two ones that I'm gonna show. So this is the one called Animal. Let me show you. This is how it looks on the tub. It looks beautiful. The color is beautiful, coral, kind of pinky coral shade, which looks absolutely stunning. Let me give you a quick swatch. Can you see that? How patchy this looks. I've applied it here. It looks extremely patchy, guys. It doesn't sit on your eyelids well. This just again crumbles, and the powder just settles in the fine lines of your eyes, and it is not cute. I don't really like this product. And the other product that I get from the same range is called Bubbly. Beautiful shade again. It's a nice light pinky glittery shade. Looks gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And again, let me give you a swatch. It's very, very dry on the pan. The other shade that I showed is also very, very dry on the pan. So let me swatch it here for you guys. I hope you guys can see. Again, it is not at all pigmented, guys. It's very, very, very patchy. Yeah. It's broken. I don't know if I've received the damaged piece or the defective piece, but doesn't sit well on the eyelids. It's very dry, patchy, doesn't apply beautifully like the other one does. So I'm not a very big fan of that, guys. So these are the products that I really, really regret buying, and I'll never recommend But the products that didn't work for me might work for you. So it's very, very subjective. And the last product that I have for you guys is a brush, which is from Pack 045. It's a fan brush. So guys, the brush quality is good. It's very soft and all that. But the problem is it sheds a lot. Like you can see it sheds, like see, just like that, when you touch only this just sheds. So I don't really like it. It has shed a lot. So it used to be a little thicker than this, but it has shed a lot of hairs. And also I don't like to use fan brush for highlighters these days because I don't like my highlighters to be very, very defined. I like a very nice wet look, but this doesn't give you that. This defines your highlighter like anything, which I'm not a very big fan of. So yeah guys, so yeah, that's what I have for you all. So these are the products that I really, really regret buying. I won't reach out to this anymore, and these are just sitting in the vanity. I'm just gonna throw it guys because I don't really like it. And yeah, these are the products that I wanted to show you. And do let me know in the comment section what are products that you regret buying. I would be you know, it would be so interesting for me to read up your comments. And if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and also post your valuable comments, and I'll catch you all in my next video. Bye.